We're going to do just a little bit of a walk around to begin with here. I'm going to show you a couple of things I've done. Just trying to keep you updated. This, of course, everybody's seen these. It's the Harbor Freight electric chainsaw sharpener. I've attached a couple of brackets. These are just metal brackets that you can get from the building stores like Lowe's, Home Depot, whatnot. And I've drilled a couple of 3/8 holes in the brackets in such a manner as it tilts it, the I believe it is 9 to 11 degrees for the tooth profile. And you can see a little bit of the tooth profile right there. And that is so that the wheel comes down and will contact at the proper angle to cut that. So I've got it mounted. That's about all I've done there. Here is going to be the lifter. It's small ball bearing. It's a 5/8 OD with a 1/4 inch ID. I bought a tube of 10 off from eBay, and I've also used that here. Put it inside of an eyelet. Okay, I just opened up that eyelet a little bit and pushed that bearing in with a vise. There are two more bearings down here mounted on a 1/4 inch bolt, and they help that blade slide. Okay, I have put a couple of more in the back. I'm going to show them to you right here. As this thing is turning, and you'll see it in a minute, you'll see it turn, it wants to pick the blade up on this side. For what reason, I don't know. I will continue to work on that, but to stop it, I just put a washer on the top, and it just forces that tooth down to where I want it to be when this thing is running. Okay, now, as I said in the last video, the cam, I'm working on it. If you watched the last video, you saw this bent sheet metal strap. The screw is on the flat side of the shaft, and that's what drives it. Okay, the little motor, I'll get over there and give you a shot of that. There it is. It's on that orientation right now in the box. I put 2x4 box, handy boxes below. I will use those, one for just a regular outlet switch, and the other one for the duplex. And the duplex will hold the wall wart, which is currently down here. And the other side will be for the grinder, to start and stop the grinder. So if you give me just a second, I'm going to put this in the tripod. Okay, and we'll start it up and let you see it. This is my progress so far. I really haven't worked on it every day. I bought another motor scooter, and I've split my time on that. So here we go. Just plug it in. You'll see it advance the blade. Currently, what you're going to see is I didn't put the position of this screw in the right place, and it's advancing 2 teeth every time. But the little motor seems to be plenty powerful enough. The next thing that we do is put the cam in place, build the cam, and a lever to pick up the grinding motor and follow the profile of that too. Okay, so again, just a little video to show you where I am so far. I will post that bearing number. They're really quite cheap. They don't have to be much. They're just guides mostly. Okay, thanks.